你好，Welcome to Chinese for Leaders at the Next Generation. 我是你们的汉语老师，范老师。Today we're going to learn, can you speak Chinese? 你会说汉语吗？ So let's get started. For today's contents, first we're still the same. We're gonna review a little bit of lesson 4. And then we continue lesson 5, can you speak Chinese?At the end of today's course, I'm going to introduce a little bit about the Chinese basic, character's basic structure. So let's start it from the review. The first one we're going to review is measure word. If you still remember, the measure word structure will be numbers plus measure word plus noun. You always need a measure word in front of a noun. If you don't use noun at all, if you don't use measure word at all, it doesn't make quite sense for Chinese people. If you don't know which one to use, you better just choose 个. For example, 三口人, three people. 三口人, 口 is the measure word for family members. It literally means mouth. Or 一个学生, 一个学生, one student.个 is the measure word for student, or it's a relatively general measure word for everything, for like cups, for like a mobile phone, or a computer, both okay. So after knowing the measure word, and we also learned there is a retroflex final in Chinese. This one can express the fondness feeling towards something,or describe something has small light features. For example, 花儿、小鸟、饭馆、and 小孩。This one you can show your cuteness. But one thing is, if this is not a retroflex final, it's a syllable read as 儿. For example, 女儿. And then in that way, that 儿 you have to pronounce as a syllable instead of the retroflex final.Okay, so this is what we learned yesterday, and then we also learned how to ask the sentence about how many people in your family. 你家有几口人？几 is an interrogative question word asking for numbers under or around 10. 你家有几口人？ Your family has how many people? How many people are there in your family?我家有三口人 My family have three people. 我爸、我妈和我 My dad, my mom, and me. And what about your family? 你呢? Okay, this is what we learned about yesterday. And then we continue for today's lesson. Lesson 5, can you speak Chinese? Before that, we started to learn some new words. First one is...会, 会 is a modal verb, and I'm going to introduce this modal verb in the grammar part. It means can or be able to do something. 会 Second, 说, to speak. 说 Third, 怎么, 怎么 literally means how. Then last one, 读读, to read. Continue. 听, to listen. 听, to listen. 写, to write. 写. 汉字, Chinese characters. 汉字, Chinese characters. So 汉, it's actually, literally means the Chinese national people.The majority, 95% of Chinese people is Han people. So the language, the characters we're using, the culture we're sharing, majority is Han people's culture and characters. But there are also some minorities living in China as well. They have their own language, culture, and different customs. Alright, the last character is Yong.To use, 用, to use. Now, let's review one more time. 会, 会, 说, 说怎么怎么读读听听写写汉字汉字用用 Alright, let's say the modal verb. The modal verb's structure, it will need to be put in front of the verb and after the subject. So for example, 我会说汉语 I can speak Chinese. 我会说汉语 Or for the negative format of this one, you can say put a 不 in front of 会 So this is 我不会说汉语我不会说汉语 Here this 不 should be rising tone Rising tone, read as rising tone 我不会说汉语 Okay, so this 会 is actually indicating you have ability through learning So 说汉语 is an ability you don't have naturally and it's something you learned later through effort. So 会 is normally used for action you learned later or by learning. So let's read one more time. 我会说汉语。我会说汉语。我不会说汉语。我不会说汉语。Okay, let's see if you can see this. Do you know this activity? I can ask one by one. 你会游泳吗？你会游泳吗？ Your answer could be 我会游泳 or 我不会游泳。Continue.你会唱歌吗？你会唱歌吗？ Your answer could be 我会唱歌 or 我不会唱歌。Third 你会画画吗？你会画画吗？ Your answer can be 我会画画 or 我不会画画。Number four, 你会踢足球吗？你会踢足球吗？ Your answer could be, 我会踢足球 or 我不会踢足球。You can pause here and try out again. Alright, let's see the first context. So, 张丽 asked 马丁，你会说汉语吗？你会说汉语吗? Can you speak Chinese? 马丁说,我会说汉语。I can speak Chinese. I can speak Chinese. And then Zhang Li asked again, 你妈妈呢?你妈妈呢? He said, 她不会说。她不会说。你妈妈呢? It's abbreviated. The 呢 used for abbreviated the first question, can you speak Chinese?And then change the subject to how about your mom? And then Ma Ding says, 她不会说汉语。她不会说 abbreviated from the previous sentence. Let's say this one more time. 你会说汉语吗?你会说汉语吗?我会说汉语。我会说汉语。你妈妈呢?你妈妈呢?他不会说，他不会说。Okay, 好 let's continue. So there's another interrogative pronoun in this lesson called 怎么。So 怎么 is used before a verb to ask about the manner of action. How do you do this action? You're going to use 怎么。For example, how do you read your name? How do you read your name? Let's give the subject 你的名字。你的名字 how to read, 怎么读怎么读 how to read, 怎么读 So your name, how to read it, 你的名字怎么读? You can just pronounce your name. And also, I introduce you another very useful sentence. How do you say something in Chinese? So we use the word 用. 用 means to use. 用汉语. 用汉语, use Chinese. 怎么说? How to speak? Hello. 用汉语怎么说? Hello. 用汉语怎么说? Thank you.用汉语怎么说? You're welcome. So whatever you can put at in the quotation marks for hello, and you can replace the other things. Or you can put hello in front of the entire sentence. For example, you can say, hello, 用汉语怎么说? Hello, 用汉语怎么说? Okay, you can either put it at the very end,or put it in the very beginning. But the major structure will be 用汉语怎么说? Use Chinese, how to speak. 好, let's continue. So Ma Ding asked a new guy, this guy, he said, 用汉语怎么说? Thank you. 用汉语怎么说? Thank you. How do you use Chinese to say thank you? And then this guy answered, 谢谢。谢谢。And then ask, Ma Ding want to know how to write the characters. So Ma Ding say, 谢谢的汉字, the characters of 谢谢。谢谢的汉字怎么写? How do you write the characters of 谢谢? And then he said, 哦,对不起, I'm sorry, 我会读,不会写。I can read, but cannot write.Let's say it one more time. 用汉语怎么说? Thank you. 用汉语怎么说? Thank you. 谢谢。谢谢。谢谢的汉字怎么写? 对不起,我会读,不会写。This is today's major lesson.For using how to ask something, or the modal verb 会. Last part, I'm going to introduce you the character basic structures. The character fall into two types of structures. One is the single component structure and the component structure. So basically, Chinese characters fall into two types of structures. One is the single component structure and the compound structure. The formal has only one component, for example, 我, which means you cannot separate this, it's only just one structure. Or China's 中, 中国的中, this one you cannot separate them, it's composed by structures.But there's no component. Structure made component. And the component put together, which is the character. Or you have another structure, which is multiple component, which contains more than one component. And this is a compound structure. And then, as you can see, this one is obviously a left-right structure. You will see this single standing personradical later in the other characters. Actually, we already learned one, which is 他, the male 他. And then for 谢谢的谢, for this one, you will say this is a left, middle, and the right structure. So it has three parts of one structure. Now, do you get it? Can you find some similar characters compared with these ones?One is a single component. What is a single component and what is a multiple component? All right, I'll leave you here. And then this is today's lesson. I will see you tomorrow. 再见!